while traveling, pay attention that all the hoses do not go like this, because they will be damaged over here, the road brake, and it can start to leak if you pressurize it afterwards. So if you see something like this happening, make sure you cut it off, clean connection. First thing you also need to do is make sure that all pots are without any pressure, meaning turn down the pressure and make sure that this one is closed, so that no pressure can go from the regulator into the pot. Same one for this. And make sure that atomizing air from the spray gun is turned all the way down. Now when you connect the system, everything is without pressure, start rate zero. The first thing you have to do is make sure that the basic settings on the regulators are okay. Meaning, we normally start with around 0.8 bar, which is around 10 psi on the adhesive. For the activator, we start with a pressure of around 8 psi. Open this. Make sure that you check if adhesive or activator is coming. In this case, only activator. Because this one is still closed. On both pressure pots, there is a ball valve. So if you want to check either the adhesive or the activator, just close one. In this case, adhesive is closed, activator is open. To check if activator is coming. The other way around, open adhesive, close activator. To check if adhesive is coming. Now the one thing we are going to do to check the ratio, to see if both are coming in the right quantity, is take two cups, put them in your hand, open both ball valves, and make sure that your air cap and material outlet are separated on both cups. So one cup is catching the activator, one cup is catching the adhesive. Open it. Time is not an issue because time for both parts are the same. Close it. And then we are going to check the weight. Meaning, take the scale, put on an empty cup, turn the scale on to make sure that it is on zero with the cup on it. That if you change the cup, you measure only the content and not the cup itself. So in this case, we got 9.3 grams of adhesive versus 5.4 grams of activator. This gives a ratio of 1 to 1.8, meaning not okay. So in this case, we need more adhesive because we are going for a ratio of 6 parts adhesive or 1 part activator, meaning we need more adhesive. Turn up the pressure, more pressure, more materials come out, as well for the adhesive as for the activator. We're going to around 16-17 psi on the adhesive now. Take two empty cups again, do the whole procedure again. See what we got? Take an empty cup again, put it on zero. In this case we got 29.1 grams of adhesive, 7.1, meaning we are on a ratio of 4 parts of adhesive more or less versus 1 part activated. So still we need a bit more adhesive. So what we do is turn up the pressure a little bit more. Make sure that the nozzles are clean. Two more clean cups. Take the clean cup again. check if it's still on zero, which it is. This case we got 23.6, 7, as he said. 3.8, activator. This gives a ratio of 1 part activator, 6 and a little bit on the V-sip. A-OK. Always make sure that you clean all the cups, because it's also easy to knock one over and make mess. So what we normally do is pour all the content in one cup, including the activator. Make sure that it is out of the way so that you cannot wrap it over. Before you actually start spraying, make sure that you check one last time if all the openings are clean and open. Turn off the pressure. It's part of a 2K system. The atomizing air should be around 35 psi. You need 35 psi to make sure that both components mix together very well. If you get less, mixture of both components will not be okay because they are not mixing all the way through. So 35, 40 psi is what you will need minimum. If you did everything okay, you will see that adhesive is coming out, activator is coming out, and they're both mixing together. Next thing you need to do is to check if the ratio you just put in your system is actually giving you the results you want to have. Two things can happen. Three things can happen. You can either have the right ratio, which will give the perfect result. If you have too much adhesive, or if you have too much activator. Both last cases you can check very easily visually on how does my spray pattern look, how does it fall to the foam. Am I using too much adhesive? Am I using too much activator? We will manipulate our system to show what you can see. Too much adhesive, too much activator. First, what you do is take a scrap piece of foam. Now, with the right ratio, you will spray a little bit. The spray pattern should be nice and even. And if you put both parts together, you should see legs of adhesive, and if you open it a little bit, the adhesive is giving resistance and stays on both sides. And pay attention to the fact that there are no water bubbles inside. This is the result as it should be. Now for the next test, we'll just put up activator, so I'm giving too much activator. To manipulate it even a little bit more, I'll give less adhesive. So at this moment you can see it even, the activator is actually spraying through the adhesive, but just to give you a view of what's going to happen. Spray pattern looks okay. As soon as you make the bonding, what happens is that you can open it too easily and you can see that certain spots the adhesive is gone. So you will take the adhesive off one of the substrates. This is kind of easy foam, so it will stick a little bit to the substrate. The more difficult the substrate, the more easy it will come off one side completely. The resistance is not enough. The adhesive is more or less dead. For the next one, and that's something where you will see more adhesive time, you will put too much adhesive. Turn down the activator. So in this case, the ratio is such a way that you have, let's say, 20 parts of adhesive and 1 part of activator, so you are using way too less activator. Once you spray it, you'll see that you first of all put on a lot of adhesive, but it's also dark blue. And when you make the bonding, if you look closely, and I hope you can see it on the video, you will see little water bubbles inside the bonding. Now the fact that you see water bubbles means that there's too much water inside, not enough coagulated material. So check for water bubbles. If you see them, you're using too less activator. when you are spraying with a two-part system, always make sure that you pull the trigger all the way to the back. Inside are two needles. Both needles need to be all the way back to give you the right ratio. If you do not pull it back, the ratio will be different than what you have set on your pressure tank system. So when you spray, all the way back. Again, always all the way back. Not like halfway, because strange things will happen. All the way will give you the right ratio. Otherwise, you will have guaranteed you will have not the right ratio.